One of the most important goals of the USTA here at the National Campus is to make sure its players are fit and healthy and injury-free as they fan out to conquer the tennis world. And they accomplish this through a partnership with the Nemours Children's Health System. Nemours is a nonprofit pediatric health system with facilities throughout the eastern United States, and they have doctors and therapists on site here at the National Campus. We're pleased to welcome Dr. Sarah Gibson, who is a member of the Department of Orthopedics at Nemours. Thanks for being here. There are physicians like yourself from Nemours on site here at the National Campus all the time. Tell us what you guys do to help the players in the player development program.
Well, in the player development program specifically, it's a really cool program where they try to identify and then naturally develop the top young players in the United States with the goal of really creating the next round of world-class tennis players from the United States. And so we absolutely take care of them when they have medical issues, but we also try to help them prevent getting injuries, and we also try to make sure that they have maximal health so that they can really perform to their best ability on the courts.
Nemours has facilities in five states, including Florida. Tell us about the organization's mission.
Well, the mission is to treat every child as though they were our own child, and really to take care of any child, regardless of what their financial situation is, and just to provide the top medical care in the world, really, for all children with medical issues.
Talk about the challenges of treating pro athletes. I know you can't speak about specifics because of HIPAA laws and privacy and all that, but I imagine it's got to be difficult at times to balance, on one hand, their desire to rehab quickly to get back on the court with, on the other hand, what's in their long-term best interest health-wise.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head. Absolutely. Time is one of the most important factors for any elite athlete, and any time away from training or competing is a major issue for them. So trying to get them in quickly, address their issues as quickly as possible, work them up, and then, yes, try to get them safely back to their sport as quickly as possible is critical.
I want to circle back to something you said at the top about the player development program, and part of what they do here in concert with you is identifying athletic potential for young players who have the chance to do something great. What kind of testing do you do on young athletes to help determine what their physical potential might be?
We do have a really neat program as part of the preseason program where, you know, we as the physicians are not the ones who identify who the top players are. But when some of the top young players are coming through here, we can do a wide range of tests. We do a physical exam on them. We do blood work to make sure they don't have anemia, to make sure their electrolytes are good, their thyroid studies. we also do DEXA scans to look at their bone mineral density to make sure they're not at high risk for stress fractures. We can also get their body fat content through DEXA, and it's actually one of the newest ways and the most accurate way of determining body fat content. We can do echocardiograms, EKGs to make sure they don't have any cardiac issues, and then VO2 max testing to look at their endurance and ability to recover. So it's a really wide, all-encompassing medical evaluation to see if there are any problems that could affect their ability to participate, but also to find little things that we can tweak to make sure that they're really going to be performing at the top level.
All right, since I have an orthopedist sitting at this desk who specializes in tennis, I have to ask this question on behalf of our viewers at home who might be club players and who suffer this all the time. What exactly is tennis elbow, and how do you avoid it? Because many of our club players suffer from it.
So ironically, tennis elbow is something that you see very, very rarely in true elite tennis players. So sorry to any players who are out there with it.
It's okay, we're over.
It's basically, it can happen quite frequently when you have too much wrist on your backhand. It can happen other ways too, but it's a lateral epicondylitis when you irritate basically and overuse the wrist extensors.
And how do you not do it? How do you not get your lateral epicondylitis, if I said that right?
I guess you have good form on your backhand.
Okay. But so that's why pros don't generally get it, because they know what they're doing.
Yeah.
In particular, you are a pediatric orthopedist, and I wanted to ask why it's important, if you have a young student athlete, why it's crucial that they see an orthopedist that specializes in pediatric injuries as opposed to a run-of-the-mill grown-up orthopedist, because it's a specialty.
Yeah, well, and, you know, it's I'm very lucky to work at Nemours. We're one of the largest children's healthcare systems in the United States, as you'd mentioned. And we actually have the largest pediatric orthopedic group with over 30 pediatric orthopedic surgeons across our sites. But young athletes are different than older athletes. They still have open growth plates. And this can put them at risk for injuries that adults don't even get. And then sometimes it can mean that you would treat an injury differently in a young player than you would in an old player. For instance, if someone my age got a meniscus tear, there's a very low likelihood that a repair would work because I just don't have good blood supply to most of my meniscus anymore. But in a young player, you actually would try to repair a meniscus tear if you could.
All right, before I let you go, I just have to check your comedy chops. Doctor, it hurts when I go like this.
Then don't do that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sarah Gibson from Nemours, thank you for being here.
Thanks
for keeping the American players healthy.